Good morning, grasshoppers. In the top right, we're following Ding Liren as White versus Nepo. Hello, grasshoppers. Jalloul is a Lebanese chess champion for women. You can always look up more information on them. She won the Arab Under 18 Women's Championship in 2007 and then the Lebanese Women's Chess Championship in 2009.
You do. No question.
Good morning.
Said. Yo.
Impracticed. Thank you for the follow. Namaste. I am FIDE trainer and national master John MacArthur.
Thanks for following.
Make sure that you join the dojo. I don't know when that message comes up, but this is the Rapid and Classical Dojo today. This is where you'll find us anyway. I also message on a regular daily basis the Master Chess Dojo.
I say you do.
In practice.
Siddhant Kapatia. Good morning, and thanks for the follow. Wow, it started already? Suddenly, we are off. And I meant to do a survey of what openings I need to play. I know that I need to catch up on the French. I've not played enough Frenches. The two knights variation, perhaps? A very unusual exchange variation. This is a good example of where we might need to get rid of their strong bishop. Now, while the opponent is going for symmetry, we are going for keeping them from getting castled. Can we do that? That's a good question. Knight to g5 could be annoying. Continuing our development. Do we wish to prevent? So can I play c5 here? g4, knight takes d4, knight takes d4, c takes d4. Ah, it looks interesting. Oh, what you doing after the show? A secret rendezvous. Very loose here, in fact. Very, very, very loose. Now where is the queen going? This looks like it's a little overworked, doesn't it? Queen has to stay on the knight.
In practice,
said
he did blunder, I believe. Some kind of sign. You sure look that way to me. Let's keep up the pressure on that knight. Are we skewered? That is the question. It does look like we're skewered. So it looks like we have to continue prodding those weaknesses. And now, can we capture a pawn in front of our king? I don't really want to capture a pawn in front of the king. Trying to find the best possible square for our knight.
In practice,
said, check him.
Yes, I could check him. Or can continue to simplify. Is he pinned? Looks like it. I mean, he is getting the knight back, but it's just not pretty. Not pretty at all. How are we doing a Nepo Ding? Nepo is, decisively worse. Hold on here. Ron? Oh no, not Ron. What am I going to do against Ron? Of all of the moves that I still have to catch up on that I need to play, let's go with b4. I cannot disrespect Ron with g4.
In practice,
said, checkmate, and after he played pawn b right.
Well, b takes c, rook to d2, rook to e2 more than likely. Yeah, it looks like he's checkmated. You are absolutely correct. Are you in the tournament in practice? If you've not yet joined the Discord, now is the time. If you've not yet subscribed on YouTube, it would be very much appreciated. When you love someone. When you love someone. We're just going to continue developing. My interpretation.
In practice.
Said. No, I just woke up and to make something to eat as well.
This time I wanna be sure. I don't really want to lose any more time with that knight. Or with that pawn. But it doesn't look like I have much of a choice, do I? Interesting. Alright. It is unfortunate that we have to lose a little bit of time here. So good when we make love, it's so have I lost enough time in this opening to give away equality? When you love some. Let's see, so just played in Nepo versus Ding. Knight takes c4, rook c7 is coming, queen to g5, I see. So knight e3 has to happen. If the pawn goes to a4, knight e3 threatening rook c7, rook c8. Tough call over there, yes. Meanwhile, so of course, knight e3 has to be played in Nepo versus Ding in order to cut the queen off from g5 to threaten rook c7. Rook to g8, rook to c7, bishop to e4. Is he going to be fast enough? So now, our opponent is threatening knight to g4. Well, let's prevent knight to g4. Playing Ron Hay while watching the World Chess Championship in the bottom right hand corner. Nepo versus Ding. 93 as predicted. Pretty obvious move. So now Black has a choice of Bishop e4. Is that really a candidate move? After Bishop e4, what is wrong with Rook to c7? I guess we can always play that move.
In practice,
said, the only good move he have is just to castle.
Well, no, he's still threatening us. That's why we developed our pizzas. So now, after knight on g to e2, bishop g4, queen g3. Knight to h5. Queen takes g4. Yeah, we'll just continue developing. Continuing our development. All right, so now the problem is castles, bishop g4, queen g3, knight takes e2, bishop takes e2. All right, fine. And we're going to lose on the e4 square, the b5 square if we recapture with the knight as much as we want to do that. Now for something completely different. Taketh, taketh. Knight to let's just prepare against anything that he's going to do to me. Think I should be going, yeah. Keeps on rolling. Ba-dump, 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 ba. So he's got to take on c4 first, it looks like. But then the d6 pawn is hopelessly backwards. Or is it hopelessly backwards? Let's see if we can keep the pressure going here for Ron. Is he going to take twice? And do we have anything? He's definitely getting d5 in. Knight to d5, knight to f4. The pressure on my f2 square is getting rather unbearable. Don't forget about me after I've been gone. Oh. Unfortunately, I have to solve the problem of my knight being tied down there. Chess. Takes. Think I should be going, yeah. Time doesn't wait for me. It's on going. Yeah, I'm a little decoyed. What's holding that up? Queen to g3? Bummer. Taking my time. Oh no! That was not in the plan. Maybe c4 was supposed to be in the plan? Does Ron have me here? He could well have me here. Such a bummer. Mm-hmm. Yes. He could have me. Sail across the stormy seas. That's what it takes me, baby. So how much you mean to me. Ouch. He's threatening mate with a pawn? That's kind of rude. Spent my life so foolishly. Found you. Together we'll make history. Threatening mate. How rude of you, sir. When you throw sand in someone's face, that's what you get.
In practice.
Said. GG.
Pegasus sweat.
Said.
Yes, indeed. B4, indeed. Let's see if we can get a few more people from this particular one. Future champion. When you're playing against someone like the future champion, it's best to play solidly. Looks like Ding is bringing home the point, folks. Rook to e8, knight to d5. Alright, moment of truth. The rook to b1 line, eh? Fair enough. Can we mix this up a little bit? Feeling kind of down about the dues you've been paying. Oh. Following Kasparov. Sorry, Kramnik versus Kasparov here. People living in competition. Have my piece of mind.
In practice,
said Castle LOL.
Yes, I'm always looking for something else, though. I understand about indecision.
Said. Got it.
Always looking for something far more creative. That's what the laws of this, or at least in these positions. So bishop to g4. Rook takes b7. Bishop takes f3. Am I really in trouble on the back rank? That is the question. Or do we just play b6? No, we can't play b6. But you're absolutely right. We do want him to move as king. And we do want to activate our pieces as fast as humanly possible. And now, since he didn't move as king,
Lunacat
said, "Hi, Mr. Lunacat.
How are you?" Well, this does stop me from playing what I want to play.
Lunacat
said, "Not watching the world championship."
We are watching the world championship. It's in the box to the right. After the rook moves, knight back to d5 looks equal.
Good, how are you?
But does he have anything here after knight to f5?
practice.
Said. Pawn to E.
E6, you mean? E6. D6. B6. Yeah. No, I was already considering that possibility. I was going looking at E5 as well.
Said.
I guess the back seating does affect things in a way. I mean, I was already going to play E6. If I was not planning on playing E6, that would be a different problem. Yes. And now he's threatening bishop to b5. So we have to actually capture. As an in-between move. This was the only move, by the way. The only move that we could have considered. Just had to make sure he didn't play d6.
In practice,
said. You could have taken the pawn on.
In practice.
Could have taken the pawn on e4. Yeah, but then he would have taken on d7. I take on f3. This is starting to look pretty, pretty sporty, if you ask me. So now. Now, what's protecting the rook? What's protecting that rook? As the last rook comes into the game. I mean, I don't blame everyone for watching the World Chess Championship. So what were the moves played? Knight e7, rook f8.
Lunacat
said, intense game.
I mean, everything is winning for white for the most part, but we just have to have a nice amount of time remaining to be able to do it. Queen to d6. Rook to b8. Yeah, rook to b8 and rook. Yeah, rook to b7 and rook to b8 seem like the most logical moves. There's nothing black can do, can he? So rook to b8, queen to g5 is stopped because the bishop is hanging. Queen takes g5, fg5, rook takes b1, a2, knight to g6, check, king to g8. Knight to g6, check, bishop takes g6, h takes g6. What can he do? H takes g6 to stop.
Impractisk.
Said. Pawn to h.
H4?
Said. Or king to e.
Hold on, where are we? What are we talking about here? Are we looking at this game? So on the previous move. Yeah, h4 seems reasonable. King to e5 probably was better. But this looks pretty handy. There's no winning the game after this. There are no squares for Black's knight. It's a wee bit of zugzwang. But who's in zugzwanging who? This is starting to look a little sketchy. Knight to d5. Wow, the whole world is falling. A3. The pawns are stymied for now. They can't move. So A3. Knight moves, knight F check. And knight to d5 to take that one. Hurrah, Charish. We can watch it from here. Wait a minute. How do I make this bigger? I do need a board focus. How about that? I'm gonna create a board focus for the top left. What is the time situation over there? Can't see the clocks. Let's take a quick look at the clocks. While we have time. Can we see the clocks? They're not broadcasting the times on the clocks, maybe because they're inaccurate. Well, Ron was held to a draw, so he's within shouting distance, but I don't get to play him again. The best thing about a Swiss system is the fact that you only get one game against each opponent, and you have to make that game count. And hopefully we'll get one more game out of this. Let's give Hunter G4. Then we'll look to see how many we need of each. We forgot to check our opening stats to see what we need.
In practice,
said Ding Loren got minutes and Nipomniachtchi got HR and minutes.
Oh, because they made 40 moves. Excellent. Thank you so much, Impractisk. Namaste for that information. So Diglerin has an hour, a little less than an hour, and Nepo, with bad time management, I mean, a player at that level will work out the absolute best move. Just like they're solving exercises in Puzzle Streak. Taken by the sky. I don't believe in protecting the pawn. But it's what we have to do. I need to play this better than a player played it against me some time ago. I basically won in 22 moves with black using a very similar system to the one that they are playing here. So we're going to fight for the white squares. Could have also played b3 and bishop to b2. Gone for the weak square. Till it's gone a little too late. What? Takes. Let's go this way. Gotta take the one that's hanging. Takes a lot of getting used to learn to live with it. But I don't want to. Tagging B7. And now? Knight to B4? I don't know. Every reason. Whoa. So we're trading rooks? Alright. Fine. Is an endless fight. Takes a lot of getting used to learn to live with it. So I always have King C3 until I don't. So I have to play it this way. Is he escaping? Takes a lot of getting used to. Takes, 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 takes. King moves. I have to go for it. So he's got knight takes e4. I mean, I have a very close to winning endgame if I don't allow him rook takes d3, but he always has knight takes e4 check. That's annoying. Right?
In practice,
said Dingle Ren winning.
Dinglerin is definitely, definitely winning. That much is true. Still they try to see why something good. He rushed that move a little bit. He needed to play a5, I think, so that he could play knight f2 on king g2. But he does have this. So what can I do here? Many wrong or rights. Neither could change their headstrong ways. And in a lover's rage, they turn another page. The fighting is worth the love they say. Where does he go? Where does he go? Let's not get too fancy. You can't cry. Yes, yes. D5 he settled on. That is one of the slowest moves one could ever imagine to win this game. But if a2, rook takes a2, bishop takes a2, knight g6 check. I think he's going to pick up the piece on the other side of the board. Even though we like the plan. They really think this is a blunder? The chat has no idea what is going on. Wow. I think we miscalculated here, Hunter.
Good morning, light the beam.
Good morning, DG. How you doing, Danny? It is a beautiful morning. There is zero defense. What was the name of the last Super Bowl team that had zero defense? That's what I'm reminded of here. Zero defense. All offense. Yep, Dingler in, doing pretty well. Rook takes a2. Is planned, right? Well, the computer likes everything else.
Said, light the beam in Sacramento like it's last night's Kings game was cool.
I'll have to check it out. All I want to do in the morning is see your eyes. Rosanna, Rosanna.
Grode.
Rosanna. All right, now for the moment of truth. And I have to say, could I have played knight to c7 check first? No, we're going to consolidate and we're going to attempt to win this game on both sides of the board. Rosanna, Rosanna. Rosanna, yeah. She's gone, and I have to say. Uh-oh. I got a little miscoordinated. Rook to b6 could have been awkward. I wouldn't have been able to get up in time, maybe. Can I go this way? Oh, what's the fastest way to get my knight to b6? Since she went away. Now all he needs, it appears, oh, does he have that? Meet you all the way. Well, that's a bummer. Oh no. Oh no, did I lose this? Shoots, I lost it. I can't believe that I lost this game.
Said, and he sacrificed the Ruuk.
What? I mean, it's true that I'm threatening this move, but he does have the sacrifice of the Rook. Yes.
Said, what?
White is winning with Rook takes e5 check. Yes. I blundered with c7. I'm doing very okay here if I play knight check first. I'm like not losing at all. Knight check, knight takes pawn, and then I start the whole process all over again. Because I can mate with bishop.
Unacceptable liquidation
offer. Unacceptable indeed, but it won the game. Oh no, and I didn't check to see whether I needed more g4 or more b4. Well, I'm doing very okay with g4, as it turns out. The children, any way they could. Exposing every weakness, however carefully hidden by the kids. Home the fat and psychopathic wives would thrash them within inches of their lives. Wow. I got away with that? Basically, D takes C4 was a little bit problematic. But he was going to have two pieces hanging after Queen takes d1, King takes d1, Bishop takes g4, check f3.
Grove.
Said, Ding is about to checkmate.
Nice. He is about to checkmate. Mate in 8, according to the engine. It's unbelievable, this World Chess Championship.
Play the game to mate so much material about how to bounce back.
Grove.
Said.
Basically, queen takes g8 is mate. A1 equals queen is the only move. Well, maybe it's not the only move. A1 equals rook also works. Queen f4 checks, stymies the mate. I think there's going to be a handshake. They say d5 was beautiful. Let me just see what the concept was here. D5, and that set up the mating net. The hook mate. D5 was indeed a beautiful move. A beautiful myth. Alright, we're gaining time, folks. We're gaining time. Another brick in the wall. Oh, you're just another brick in the wall. Do I want to exchange that? I do not. I want to go after the weakness on that square.
Practice.
Said. And he resigned.
Grode.
Said. Let us watch the press conference.
Grode.
Said. Game is over.
Yes. Let's watch the press conference. Let's see if we can get there. I mean, we have a few moments, right? Let's see what we can do. Lee Chess TV broadcasts BDA World Chess Championship. What do you suggest that we watch the
Coburg
said. Hello.
I see it all around you.
The official one.
Good love and gone bad. Usually it's... Great. What's that?
Said.
The official one.
Answer questions.
So basically, this was a balance system, which we did not expect. Yeah, bishop f5, c3, e6. Bishop Grode. E5 is actually like
said.
Hold the phone here.
Including absurd questions from
and
Mike Klein.
Too dangerous. But the strategic idea is there, as we discussed in many lines. Besides,
it's not the same press conference without the absurd questions, though.
So Jan did not react very well, and the move we especially didn't like was, I think, 97.
Yeah.
But then actually,
said,
maybe it makes sense.
How was your day, Master Chess Dojo?
In a critical way, too, is basically you are doing nothing to stop that.
So far, so good, Foberg. I am very happy that Ding has come back. It's going to make doing the recaps that much more fun.
It is a little bit problematic for Black. It's not that simple. The line Jan played is certainly not the most ambitious reaction to London. Anyway, he ended up getting this unpleasant position with basically zero counterplay, his queenside pawns fixed, and white knight coming to c5.
Great.
After which some of her play
said, I'm going to stop by Packer, unfortunately only are there.
Offering an ending which would still be very nice for white. Jan's reply kind of made us believe sending is good for white. Actually, I think after queen is seven, h4, the engine's choice is queen c7 back, which is funny.
Yeah, so no one would ever play that move.
Yeah, so h4 was good.
Let me see if I can adjust the screen ever so slightly.
It turned out to be so useful later in the game because that pawn later on got to h5.
But it's always useful. This is 21st century. Mm. It's always useful. No, the result is actually wrong. This was not a draw, I'm afraid, after queen f7. Yeah, anyway, so here black played rook e8. And this is where it's unbelievable.
Hopefully I won't get targeted on YouTube for this particular discretion. Uh-oh, something's wrong with this picture.
Dink played knight c5 instead, and we were not sure what's wrong with e5. Neither was Jan. Rook b3 happened. Knight takes c5, rook takes c5, queen f6.
And this was a critical moment in the game. We actually had difficulty wading through this position, and the way that Dink played was not something that we'd exactly anticipated.
Right.
We kind of started to appreciate it a little bit later as he showed us the points of his move. But yeah, you can go through it quickly, but the press conference is about to start. So.
Right. So basically, Dink played absolutely perfect chess later on. And after h5, bishop c2, knight takes b7, and it turns out that, you know, despite the changing of the pawn structure, white is much better. And Dink went on to win a very, very nice game.
Yeah, and guys, we're back to being tied in the match. Tomorrow is a rest day, and we will join you in 2 days for game number 7. Enjoy the press conference.
One with white pieces, and the result is 3-2-3. The first question to Dink.
This might force a resignation.
It for you to play London system today in the game, and if this was your home preparation, how many moves was the home preparation?
Well. Actually, today I was very. I'm not sure which opening to play. And last time I said
Ding won. Ding won, ladies and gentlemen. Ding won.
Occurred in the game. He played bishop f5 out of my preparation, so I just try to keep the position.
You have to have a system against the London. A system against the London that does not allow equality is ideal. Can everyone hear the desktop audio okay?
If you have expected that today the London system might be happen, and also the second question right away, what was the most challenging for you for this game?
Is the desktop audio okay, Matt?
Yeah,
Quick Chess.
Among all the openings, of course, I expected like London in one of the games, so it happened.
Pegasus Sway.
Yeah, but I guess I played
Said.
Perfect.
Yes.
One of my worst games ever.
I'm sure you can top yourself.
Said.
Audio okay.
I mean, yeah, it's hard to believe. I think every move was bad. And even then I get this second chance out of this awful position. I think it was like pretty much equal at some point if I would play bishop d3 instead of bishop c2. Yeah, even that was, unfortunate. So, yeah, bad day.
Right. If
this
I
is the volatility
ask,
that we wonder about
the,
from
the
Nepo. Can he handle it?
Started.
I mean,
Mad Geek Chess.
Oh, I mean, my whole game like,
your personal volume, there's volume level.
I mean, it all contains of inaccuracies, yeah.
Okay. Right.
There's 6 out of 10.
And the question to Ding, you have spent quite a lot of time.
It's not in the yellow on the desktop audio.
Yeah. Have you found your comfort zone right now on the table?
Yeah, I spent most of my time after he played e5, rook b3. Yeah, this was not my plan. Not
my opponent has only played one game so far.
B4 instead of rook b3.
Aditya Krishna.
So, before the position, nearly one side, I was the one who pushing, and he didn't have much counterplay, but after e5, after knight a5, suddenly he has a lot of counterplay. Yes. So maybe I'll play. I didn't play so well in the middle of the
and games, a very unusual position has arisen.
Yeah, I was very happy to find rook a5. This might be the critical move. Yeah, in general, I feel I was in very good shape during that whole game. And I was not so influenced by yesterday's lose.
I will now give the floor to the press for the questions. I'm sure you guys have a lot of questions for today's game. Please, Mike.
Thanks, Mike Klein with chess.com. My question is mostly for Grandmaster Jan Nepomniachtchi. I'd like to ask you about a very specific moment in the game. After h5, there was this very strange resource, rook takes e5, d takes e5, queen back to d8. I'm wondering if you saw this at all with ideas of queen d1 and queen h5, or did you see it and reject it because of the response queen f3?
No, I didn't see, but I somehow thought at that moment that
Fulberg said
the position is not as
heading to on chess.com, the Reedy Caitlane Benani and French defense
again,
working well me currently at rapid.
Quite
nicely done, Fulberg.
Definitely it's worse, but it's surely holdable. Perhaps after bishop c2, that's not so easy. But I guess at least some nice trick like takes in queen d8, but yeah, it's like it's not checkers, so you shouldn't. You're not forced to capture on g6.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. Next question, please.
Can I ask in Russian?
Yes, of course, you can ask in Russian.
Jan, у меня вопрос для вас. Если абстрагироваться от результата, есть ли ощущение, что вы принимаете участие в одном из самых зрелищных матчей за корону за последние 10 лет? И
thank you.
Какой матч для вас в 21 веке был наиболее интересным?
My question is for Ian. If we forget the result you've had today, so do you have an impression that you are taking part in one of the most spectacular chess events over the past 10 to 15 years?
Да, спросите в другой день.
Did you forget?
The answer is, ask me this question at some other day, please.
Fair enough. Do we have more questions?
The
photographer from here is blocking my side, so I cannot see the journalist. Okay. Yeah, go ahead, Mike. If you can, please, just a little bit. Yeah.
Mike Klein, chess.com. My question is for Grandmaster Ding Liren. At the end of the game, Anish was seeing all these checkmates on the chess.com broadcast, and he said that it was disturbing how beautiful it was. He was complimenting you. And then he said that you're a total genius. Do you agree that your game today was genius level?
Yeah, I'd like to thanks to Anish. Actually, yesterday I saw his remark. He believes I will tie the match despite I was lost yesterday. So thanks for his confidence. Yeah, today. Yeah, the game itself, I feel very, very pleased with
Fulberg
ideas. Many ideas
said
occur, so
I will be happy with.
Yeah,
right.
Fact, yes, this d5 followed by queen c7. Also, I was very happy to find
1600. I will be happy with 1600. We're keeping most of the numbers out of it, but no, you will not be happy with 1600.
Yesterday.
Aim higher. 1600 is a good stepping stone goal to getting where you want to go.
To just say that today's game is the worst you have ever played.
Thank you, Leoncho. I first met Leoncho in 1995 when we were doing the World Chess Championship at 19, and I helped him with his computer. And I cleaned about 30 or 40 viruses off of his computer. It was so bogged down. Unfortunately, I also recommended another computer recommendation, which was only American-made computer, Midwest Micro, and it did not work so well for him on the international scale.
Said, Master Chess Dojo, when you are is a lofty goal.
Thank you very much. Do we have more questions from press?
It's true.
Yeah, please go.
It's true. No, three, like, having that goal is good. 2350 at the moment is more or less mine, given the same circumstances.
Said,
as the stepping stone
Coburg
goal.
He is trying to say when you hit goal, the goalpost will move.
Yeah, as you get closer to the goal.
Said, heading to sounds good.
Well, the story was that today I was struggling to find which opening to play just before starting of the game. I have many choices. In the end, I decided to play this London system because actually I was not so afraid of, it's hard to say. I just want to play something I was more familiar with.
I have to free up some VIPs. I think I prefer Matt Quick Chess as a VIP. Now that I look at it.
Opening, I think, shoot my
I'm not sure what the difference is, if there's any serious difference. But VIP looks better, and Matt Quick Chess certainly earns it. Been here since early on as well. But we'll see. I'm not sure who's ahead, Matt Quick Chess or DG Road in the donations. They're both very supportive in their bits. I have to do one for DG Road. A little bio information. Ask him anything. He knows what's going on in U.S. chess.
Runs low in certain situations. Why is that?
Sorry, again?
Do you find that your patience runs low in certain situations? Why is that?
Mad Geek Chess.
Yes.
Said.
Yeah.
Don't know who is ahead in donations. ID. Guess who has more though. He
a lot of bad moves made,
Mad Geek Chess.
In one particular game.
Said. And so I know who is better at PLO.
Ooh. Those are fighting words.
From Sand Dude, you took a lot of time.
I'm not entirely sure that either one of them are intimating at the answer to that.
The point behind it?
Pot Limit Omaha is the name of the game for those who don't know the poker aphorisms. Actually, one of the few WPT events that I've cashed in has been Pot Limit Omaha. Like, literally, I've cashed in three or four WPT online events. I haven't looked lately. I haven't set up my W-2 to receive those prizes, unfortunately. I have to do a W-9, a 1099 with them.
ID like to play live today, but only if complete move closer to poker spot.
Thank you. And the last question I have is for both players. From Emil. Why do you
nice.
Think there are more decisive games in this match than world championship matches in the past?
I'll go with Jan to answer this first.
The quality of the play is worse.
Ask me this question another day.
Sorry?
Ask me these questions like some another day.
All right, we'll keep that. What about you, Ding?
I guess the reason is maybe we are not that professional than Magnus.
Exactly. We're not yet as good as Magnus.
Said,
we appreciate that.
Do you play poker, okay. Master Chess Dojo?
Do we have more questions from press?
I do play poker.
We have, please, Maria, go ahead.
I do play on Club WPT in the United States because I can't play in New York State in any other service. And I still didn't look up who I was going to be, what I was going to be playing, but so far G4 is working for me.
Your styles of playing.
I have to look to see what I need. By the way, no one should feel offended. It's like pursue GTO.
Are we still keeping this question for the
I don't have a lot of live MTT caches, but one is PLO Vegas and one is NL Macau, both small.
And Sting?
No, it's just the same question as the previous one.
Yeah, but maybe something about your styles. Do you think it might change?
No limit Macau. That is nice.
Maybe until now there are not so many computer line happens during the opening phrase.
So early deviation from theory.
So far, Ding has not been playing any prep, honestly. He has not confessed to having prepped anything for this match. He is playing everything off the cuff like Magnus would.
Said.
Thank you. Do we
on any other day.
Questions from the press? Please go ahead and ask right now because this will be one last question. And meanwhile, I'll
do the framing on this a little better.
Small announcement, as yesterday there was a question about the coverage of the match in China. I have an information that the live broadcast.
This is the FIDE World Chess Championship official site.
Satellite channel and CCTV channels, which covers the entire country, and also a lot of news sources are covering the event, including Xinhua news.
We'll find out if I get banned on YouTube for broadcasting this within my channel. I have gotten banned for showing programs from YouTube before in my channel. I got a 30-day suspension at one time around January or December of last year through January of this year.
Commentary team?
We have a question for Ding.
But if it's a live event, there may be an exception. What I showed was a recorded.
In the end.
Like after queen takes b2 happened and then you started looking.
After I take on e5.
Uh-huh.
The first I was thinking about knight c4 take back, about queen c1, king h2, bishop d3, queen e3, queen d1, knight e5, queen h5, queen h3 take. And this end game is not so easy to win. So in the end, so I guess the other move doesn't work. So in the end, I found the last chance.
Thank you.
Nice reply.
I think we don't have any more questions from press. I don't have also more questions. And we can conclude today's press conference. Tomorrow is a day off, and I wish the players to have a nice rest day. And we will meet each other the other day. Thank you very much.
Nicely done. Nicely done, everybody.
We have a long history of supporting
Grode.
Said.
Don't risk that. Grode.
Exactly.
Said. Turn it off then.
Yeah, I'm going to go. I went as far as I could. As long as I don't do a complete broadcast, the last time I watched the entirety of a video at the request of Quadraspasky, and that, I believe, was in full violation. If you show a clip of another person's clip, I think you're okay. If you're referencing someone, now what I usually do here, this fellow is not here. I'm going to message him. Remember to withdraw.
Yeah,
come in.
Can I get some paper?
Sure.
Too long.
I put it down there so you can get to it rather than keeping pulling it out of my printer. Because I went to print something for tax season and I couldn't print.
Oh, sorry.
So I had to dig out the paper.
Thank you.
You're welcome. Remember to withdraw from a Swiss, as you'll still be paired.
Coburg
said, don't get banned, Master Chess Dojo.
Yeah, I know. No, I only get banned from, I don't think you can get banned from Twitch. So guys like David Pakman, who does like the entirety of a former guy press conference just to laugh at his ineptitude. He only does that on Twitch. I don't think he streams that exact thing to YouTube. I think he then takes the Twitch broadcast or the secondary broadcast and then goes it. You think, the question here was, do you think the old and modern Benoni is a good Can't see what that says. And I don't know when the last time it was that he messaged. But let's just see. I haven't replied to this in a while. 1 week ago. Let's go back 1 week.
It's Erina Chan.
Said. Hey, John, are up for reviewing my last OTB game?
Absolutely, Erina. Absolutely. I have a few things on my plate today. I want to do a recap. I deleted my first game recap because the quality was bad after my video was so choppy the other day. I assume that everything is good and correct today.
It's Erin a chance.
Openings give the opponent such an advantage.
Looks smooth.
Yeah, I had to set the priority of the router to give my device priority, and I hadn't done that since I had updated the router. Too great an advantage to overcome. Not to mention, none of your opponents will know they're supposed to play D5. Hacker is today, right?
It's Erina Chan.
Said. We can't see anything, John.
Oh, I was just replying to someone who'd asked me a message about, oh no, is it over? I never got a chance to catch up to Ron. I did catch up to Ron. Congratulations to Ron Hay. Nicely done, sir. All right, let's turn down the volume before we get blasted. Because I'm about to put the music back on. All right, meanwhile, we're going to Irina's last over the board game. Is it in your study?
You.
Hold on, I might still be able to get to your study. Study.
Is Irina Chan?
Said. Did I send it you?
Oh, sorry. On Discord or in this chat? I had not. Don't get banned. Exactly.
It's Erina Chan.
Said. Hold on.
But no, I think you had shared your study with me of your over the board games, and that's where I was headed. It was a private study, I hope.
It's Erina Chan.
Said. https://likeus.org/study/olfmsb.
It's Erina Chan.
Said. This is a new one.
Oh. Got it. That's okay. I will hopefully grab the PGN. Back. We'll go to viewer. What color were you, Arena? Were you black?
It's Erina Chan.
Said. Yes.
This is from the other night, right? It was from Friday night.
It's Erina Chan.
Said. Thursday, correct.
Oh, so it's a 13. No. So this is a little bit of a failed attempt at a Grand Prix attack. Now, personally, I just like this where I move right away. Because you often get d5 in these lines if you're lucky. For example, if you would play g6, knight f3, bishop to g7, the move bishop d4 runs into something along these lines where you get to play knight takes b5, knight takes b5, and then d5. And this is absolutely equal. So g6 to me is a little dubious in the sense that I'm not sure how useful it is to your position. I'm going to move this up for a moment, close that. So what do they say here? G6, E6, and D6. Yeah. The only moves that have fewer winning opportunities against the Grand Prix are A6, which is still not bad, and E5 straight away. Knight to D4. I have not considered this move. Let's see what I play. Obviously, as black, I almost always play. In my one experience against Lars Slur, I played D6, I believe.
Pegasus Sway
said, are you sure D?
In that position, yes, D5 indeed. In that position, absolutely. How many times have I played it? Usually white plays bishop to D3 in this position. Like tall versus Jinji Jashvili, or Jinji Jashvili was white against tall. I apologize.
Said QXDNC.
And the results are massively in black's favor, honestly. Oh no, you played knight f6, and the pawn can't be guarded. You play knight f6, and the pawn cannot be guarded. Usually white plays a move like e5, but, and then knight f6. Oh, a6 first, and then knight f6. Yeah. You don't allow c4. Sorry, I would have remembered that, and then you basically have a fully equal game here. There's nothing white can do, and white's given up his space advantage in the center. It's a hard move to play over the board, honestly, if you don't have any experience with it. But I have played it and won with black in the amateur team. I know Joel Benjamin was on the next board, and I demonstrated how to play this position with no knowledge whatsoever. I demonstrated this position without anything. I'm trying to remember what my opponent played.
It's Aaron Achan.
I have had players play e5 on Lee Chess. Let me just see here. What? It doesn't show that I've had players play e5. I was pretty certain that I have run into this on Lee Chess. Maybe I have not yet run into this on Lee Chess. I'll do anything. Yeah, almost all of my opponents. What? Oh, I've never had an opponent play this. I've only had opponents play knight takes d4, eh? And I lost to that person in a simul. Alright, meanwhile. F4 was given dubious by the computer. And I gave it dubious here. Now we're not worried about knight to b5 because of queen to b8, so everything's good to go.
It's Aaron Achan.
Said. Any fine.
Yep. Why did the computer criticize it? No, I think the computer doesn't think you need to go after this bishop when you have knight d4 and b5 with the same concept. So this is just slow. A6 in many closed Sicilians, and many, and let's say even in the dragon Sicilians, A6 is just considered too slow to generate counterplay. You'd rather be playing rook to B8 and B5. And you already have the bishop here. So knight to D4 will get you on path really quickly. So what do they suggest? They suggest just castles. Wow, the Eric Rosen pawn cube has arrived. One death to right, head for the other side. Leave it all behind.
Pawn cube.
It's Aaron again.
Wow.
And the black is better here, honestly. Did we sack a pawn? No, we returned the pawn. But it is a very picturesque pawn cube, I have to admit. Eric Rosen loves noting when pawn cubes arise, and he has an affinity for always recapturing for the double set of quadrangle pawns like that. So now we know where to find an Eric Rosen pawn cube if we need one. So now it seems like we're missing out on an opportunity here.
Great.
Said. Just made good Sunday morning at PLO on Brothers.
Nice. I think... No, you didn't have a choice in the matter. I was debating on relocating the knight. So I considered just for a brief moment trying to get both knights into the center, just like this. But it can still happen. And it looks really lovely for you, Arita. So here's where our loss of time has occurred. Our pawn should be going to A5 from A7.
And yes, Packer is today was hoping more of CGPS was there, but alas.
I forgot that I need to take. I need to drive someone to the train station in a little
since
bit.
All the messages were put in.
Wow. Wow, Arena.
It's Aaron Achan.
Said. Explosive F.
It's Aaron
Achan. Said. I wanted to guard F more.
I understand. Yeah, but you're blowing up your king side. Try not to make pawn moves where you're weak. You know, I'm just trying to, like, rook A7 is the third suggestion by the computer. But you're better here if you just simply trade off white's attackers. Let's go back. Let's take a step back for a moment.
R8 is better, no F now.
Yep. But I like the idea of exchanging off white's attackers and keeping control over the D4 square. You have all the time in the world to play this move after you develop your pieces. And that includes rook to a7 options, right? Let's say white plays bishop to e3, and now we go f5, undermining the knight. and they really are losing in this position.
It's Erin Achan.
Said. Okay.
So we're improving the position of our d6 pawn by doing this, right? Yeah, you don't want to weaken your king side unless you have a really good reason to. No tactics in this position.
It's Erin Achan.
So you got it.
I wanted to push,
but in a different manner.
Can reinforce the F file.
I can see that. Willing. Rook F7. Oops.
Said. CAI and Spring are there.
Nice.
It's Erin.
Yeah, both Kais.
Said. I thought RF was so weird.
It's Erin.
Well, I mean, it's somewhat logical, so given that we haven't played rook to a7 yet. Can we evict it? Felt the tables turn.
Coburg.
Said. Got go power going off in a few minutes. Bye-bye.
Oh no, I'm sorry to hear that.
Said. Spring told me he was gonna play every weekend post-skiing season.
Well, that's good. He's on his task then. Uh-oh. And now the knight is in some serious trouble. Nicely done. Trapping the rook. Good in-between move. Ouch. What a lovely display of technique. I'm queen f3.
It's Erin Achan.
Everything is falling.
Those knight jumps took me less than a second.
It's Erin Achan.
Said.
Nicely done.
It's Erin Achan.
Said. In classical match.
Velcro Dot was playing a rapid over the board tournament yesterday. I don't know if she's going to give a recap in her stream, but the only advice I had to her was to try to jot down the first X number of moves of every opening and every game, just so that you'll have something to study later. You are allowed to write down your moves in any time control. You just can't keep Bonin's Knights. Jay Bonin, International Master Jay Bonin in the United States Arena, is one of the most active players in the country. He plays every weekend. And we have an aspiring student, Mr. Spring, who has got a lot of Jay Bonin-esque enthusiasm. Future International Master Zachary Spring. How did it go? I'm just gonna message Valkyr Dot really quickly on what's up.
It's Erin Achan.
Said. White felt devastated after knight f was played.
Group.
Said.
Yeah.
http://www.ushes.org/msambrdtltnmthstphd.
Oh, one more. Oh no, this is the tournament route. Mr. Jay Bonin, yeah. Can you imagine?
He kept shaking his head.
Mad Geek Chess.
Said.
Bonin?
Bonin never heard of him.
Full cap from Mad Quick Chess. Full cap. The The Nassau, not Grand Prix. You know, I'm actually not far from the Nassau Chess Club. I'm actually much closer than I used to be. I should actually consider it. Monday nights, Nassau Chess Club. Do they have an address? Laurel Park. I was going to Google that one. Get my directions.
Said. HTTPS NM Wikipedia or Wiki J Bonin.
It's still an hour away from me. Oh, but that's by public transit. 20 minutes away by car. Wow, I have to really consider this.
Grode.
Said. Unfortunately, Jay has had serious health concerns the last year and a half.
Well, it's good to see that he's still playing, though. Right?
Grode.
Said. Stopping his streak of playing everything.
Yeah, this tournament was held in, February of 2014. I mean, 2022. It's quite a considerable break from playing over the board chess, if you ask me.
Mad Geek Chess
said, Grode, I am learning some stuff from the wiki, thanks.
Grode
said, not OTB in a year.
I tell you this. Yeah, Jay Bonin. I think Jay Bonin has met every significant female companion that I have ever known. He's not always been so nice. I know a couple of them
said,
we're not happy.
Legend, though Brewington visited him a couple of weeks ago, I meant to do the same.
Mad Geek Chess
said,
is he at home or is he in a facility? Didn't know the Iron Man nickname. Yeah, no, he was, he actually was very close to getting his Grandmaster norms.
Grode
said, long term facility.
Oof. What borough? Queens? God, that's terrible.
Said. Prob not too far from you.
Just because I'm in Queens. I just found out the Nassau Chess Club's, oh, it's an hour away by public transit, but you're right. He may only be about 20 or 30 minutes away from me, even if he's still in Woodside. Because he lived in, like, Woodside, Sunnyside before, and that's like 45 minutes away. It's closer to Manhattan than it is.
We can go together, I'll take LIRR out.
Sounds like a plan. We'll coordinate. Meanwhile, I'm sure the information's on Facebook. Let's check out this game from Dingler in, though, from the beginning while we're at it, since we have a little bit of time. Round 1 and 2 recaps. Got it. Round 3 and 4 recap. I'm trying to remember who's writing that. I think that's being written by Dubov. So round 6. Let's check out my games as white here for a moment. So I've played 40 G4s and 36 B4s. I need to play 64 more B4s. At least 164 more B4s. 135 or 145 more F3s. 141 C3s, another outer g3, so I can still play d3, c3, g3, f3, and whatnot. I accidentally went over by playing a4 recently. I don't remember who I played. But I can get five more h4s in. Let's turn off the engine for a moment. So this is me against Kingslayer Sloan. Queen to b6, by the way, is a terrible move. You're not really after this pawn, it's not worth it. And I was white. I take that back. I was white in that London.
The classical Sicilian is so deep it is in no way a setup opening. There are times where e4 d are in order and trying to find the right pawn break timing for it and how when to go for a counterattack is challenging.
That's correct. So that's why I usually recommend playing other Sicilians first, like the Boleslavsky style Sicilians, the Sveshnikov, and or the accelerated dragon and modern dragon first, rather than playing a let's say a Nydorf, where you have to play e5. The Nydorf is far worse because it's all memorization at a certain point. So far we're following Magnus Carlsen as white versus Aronian, Kramnik, Grishik. Nepo has never been on the black side at this particular position. And the move order is absolutely correct. This is the absolutely correct way to get into the London, only after black has given up the e5 square. For example, when I played the Torrey attack, I would play it against bishop. I'd play bishop to g5 against e6. And if the opponents played g6, you'd have another problem on your hands in this particular position. Because the move bishop to g5 is just met by knight e4. And it's not entirely so useful, but it's worthwhile. White does get a lot of play here. However, if you have to wait for your opponent to give up the d5 square, such as the e5 square, such as in this game by playing d5, now white is in business because this is where we want to go. Bishop g5 again is no longer a pin. Black is doing quite well, in fact, better than white over here statistically, because this is just a silly move against d5. That's why the London came about, in lieu of, or in essence, because of the because of the lack of control of certain squares. And white has the edge on controlling e5. Let's see how this plays out. Note there's no capturing because of the fork and the devastation of the pawn structure on the king side. We have another knight where that came from. And the dark squares are interminably weak. So this is a little ridiculous. When did he start losing the thread here? So basically this position is relatively equal, right? He should be placing his rooks in this position. I'm willing to wager that he had to place his rooks in this position. Queen to c7, rook on a to c8, or queen to b6. Or he needed to be more assertive with his knight. I've done my job. Knight to d7 was not in the top five moves as suggested by Stockfish. Locking down on the queen side pawn structure, and now the weakness of the dark squares is clear.
I'm in search for the daughter of the devil.
And now, he once again doesn't know where to place his rooks. So what can he do in this position? This bishop is really poorly placed. This is awesomely threatening. Candidate moves for black here, everybody. What's going on over there? Oh no.
Pegasus sway.
Said. BH.
Bishop H5. Definitely seems reasonable. Candidate moves for black here. I don't like rook to e8. Rook on a to b8. Queen to c7. I don't know the answer, by the way, folks. I'm just trying to... We'll pop it up in a moment. I think since we're being attacked, queen to c7 makes the most sense. Rook to c7, rook on a to b8, but black's position is so passive. Bishop to h5 has been suggested. The problem is that we can't try to expand in the center. I think this whole plan of expanding in the center goes against the grain of what black really wants. So trying to get this knight to a good square, maybe knight to a7. Knight to a7, knight to c8, knight to d6, knight to e4. How about that? And the moment of truth, everybody. Queen to c7, king h7, bishop f5, king h8, and bishop c2. But what about knight a7? Ouch. Sorry, there's an obvious threat here. Yuck. So again, knight c5, knight to bishop h7 is still somewhat forced, and we're not doing as well as Nepos. So, well, actually, they amended rook to e8 to being plus 1.3 as well. So in this particular position, one more time, again he has to take care of this bishop. Pegasus might be right. Maybe bishop f5, maybe bishop h7. I mean, he's threatening to play knight takes e6 right now. So he chose to just move the pawn, isolating his d5 pawn. Rook on a to c8, bishop f5, bishop c2. And rook a7. Isn't knight takes e6 a threat? Oh, because it's pinned. Ouch.
Said, it would be cool to see Ding win, as it would be the
so
first
no
time
knight c7
represented in holding the World Chess Championship.
Grode.
Said. https://mutube.com/watch/vpscdqseki.
No offense to all of us with unpronounceable last names, but I mentioned to a student the other day that in the history of World Chess Championships, almost all of the names have been easily pronounceable. Even at their worst, the names have been easily pronounceable. Like even Kazim Zhanov, among the FIDE world champions, has been easily pronounceable. So, for the love of God, if we get a world champion whose name we can pronounce, one syllable. Have we had a one-syllable world champion before? I think this could be our first one-syllable world champion. Steinitz, Lasker, Fischer, Tal, aha! Ting and Tal in the one-syllable world champions. Oh, I don't want that on. I want to find the best moves for ourselves. So e5 is a terrible move. Yes, Tal. Ding and Tal, and I think that's it. Those are the only two one-syllable world champions. We've always been able to pronounce the world champions' names, despite what they appear. Can you imagine journalists having to spell Nepomniachtchi, and then the entire world having to take classes on how to pronounce it? He should have changed to a stage name. Wow! Kaboom! Is he getting away with this? And he just basically exchanged off that awkward bishop as well. And now it's a good knight versus a bad bishop.
Rook B then QB if a XB when no N on C.
Grod.
Said. Karpov Fischer Spassky on und Kramnik Carlson all are hence Nepo nickname.
Yeah. So if b6, if black plays b6, then queen to b7. If a5 takes b6, no knight on c5. Hold on, what move number was that suggestion for?
Syllable last name.
Indeed. There's a lot to be said for that.
Cyber Elf Elbizo
said, Mikhail Tal was a terrifying force even on death's door. You could never count him out.
That's correct.
Said, before NC.
Oh, I see.
Kingslayer Sloan
said, John Wenyai going to give me lots of stuff for you to edit.
Grod.
Haha, Kingslayer Sloan, how are you, man?
It's used as a nickname in non-chess circles.
Yeah, obviously we have to use Nepo. How are you, Rogan? Are you streaming, buddy? Let's take a quick peek. I do not have my...
Kingslayer Sloan.
Said. I'm good man.
Pegasus Sway.
Said. Oh no, not good.
Kingslayer Sloan.
Said. How's the FM goals?
The FIDE Master goals are on the way. There we go, I finally found it. And we muted it just in time.
Grod.
said. Great chess we.
Sounds good. Chess Weave is one of my favorites. He and we have the same philosophical outlook. Yeah, it was all downhill from here, really. He really played this rather ingeniously. Let's just turn that off for a moment. So basically, he's threatening rook to c7, and in this particular position, he sets up a mating net. d5 is a question mark. What? I disagree with d5 being a question mark, by the way. d5 is a brilliant move. Another move that could also be considered here is rook to b7 and rook to b8. And it's pretty much lights out on this particular venue as well. Just too slow for black. And there's no queen to g5 because her rook takes b1 after queen takes. And there's literally no way to promote the pawn. This was ingenious. Let's take a look at the computer assessment. Like, it's a question mark move because it's less winning. Rook to b7, queen g5, fg5, and rook takes b1. That's what they're considering the best move.
Lorenzo 33
said.
Good day, Lauren. And of course, black misses his opportunity to defend. He did not see white's concept at all. Basically threatening knight to g6 check. And then simply queen takes, rook a8, and rook to f8 mate. The only moves that stop it are this, right?
Said. Exciting world championship ding strikes back.
And a hookmate with d5.
Lorenzo 33.
Said. Turns out to have a fun world championship, we just had to get rid of Magnus.
Well, it depends on whether or not you want a quality World Chess Championship match. You see, when people play against Magnus, they actually bring their game up. When you play against 1300, you know, your game sinks to the level of 1300. So it depends on whether or not you want fun chess in practice. I'm going to refund you the hydrate. I didn't see that one earlier. I just saw it, but I refunded you and I'm going to hydrate.
Groove.
Said. Magnus was enjoying his life playing Hustler Casino Live, let him be.
That's right, I haven't seen that from Friday night. I think it was
Groove.
Said.
Andrew who told me about it.
Magnus this week should be shameful.
Kingslayer Sloan.
Said,
he is enjoying poker in California.
Grode.
Said, he needed a break.
And his life is a little less private. I mean, a little more private. Kingslayer Sloan, ladies and gentlemen, Mad Quick Chess. Check these guys out. And
Lorenzo 33.
We don't want to go to Miyako.
Ding and Nepo are putting a great show on the quality ISNT as high as Magnus, but it's still very high level chess.
Where is Chessweave? There he is.
Cyber Elf Elpizo.
He's not analyzing the World Chess Championship
Magnus
match.
The world championship for years. He is entitled to a break.
Kingslayer Sloan.
But it's true that I haven't been able to raid.
House Lauren's chess goals.
Lauren, how are your goals going?
Said, I'm doing okay, taking a break for a while.
As well we should. All right, cheers and ciao, everyone. We're going to roll those ending credits. Thank you for being here.
33 said, I restated my account.
Lorenzo reinstated your account? Very good. Said,
but I'm not playing.
That's good.
Kingslayer Sloan
said, CYA John Love Yad.
Lorenzo,
thank you, everyone. Sedanka Pata in practice. If you've not yet subscribed on the YouTube, now is your chance. If you haven't joined our Discord, what are you waiting for? If you're not following me on my socials, I will follow you back unless your account is private or unless you have a very sus account. I'll let you know. You can always ask me in DMs on Discord. But cheers and ciao, everyone. Thank you very much. Have a great rest of your Sunday.